Hi, now that we're all friends, I'm Jamie again. And one thing you have to know about me if we're friends is that I love Star Wars a lot. And I think about Star Wars a lot. And I like to use Star Wars to think about my own ethics. And that's what I kind of want to talk about. So as someone who loves Star Wars, I was very excited when Rogue One was going to come out. Have people seen Rogue One, hopefully? Am I going to spoil it? They get the Death Star plans at the end, so that's a spoiler. From 1973. But I saw the preview and I was like, look at these people. There's this group of like marginalized people and they're fighting against the Empire and they're fighting against the man. It's amazing. And I'm gonna go see this movie on the first day and I'm gonna relate to these people and it's gonna be awesome. And that's not what happened. I related a lot more actually to these people in the Empire, and that was worrisome for me. And I wanna talk a little bit about why. But first, I have to talk a little bit about good and evil in general. Like, I used to feel very black and white to me, and it looks very black and white in Star Wars. Like, you can see, if you didn't know anything about Star Wars, you'd know who was good and who was bad in this picture. And it made me feel like, well, I'm a good person, so that's fine. I'm not going to do anything bad. But it's not actually that simple in real life, and it's actually not even that simple in Star Wars. Because this guy right here was actually this guy right here. And actually, most of the villains in Star Wars were originally heroes, or at least good guys that, like, accidentally became bad because of this temptation of the dark side. And it's not just the bad guys who had to face this temptation, it's pretty much everyone in Star Wars has to face this temptation. It's not like, okay, well, you're Jedi, you're good forever. But I wanna talk again specifically about Rogue One. Catalyst is the novel prequel to Rogue One, which I read before the movie because I'm really, really a nerd about Star Wars. And it's really about these two guys who you might recognize from the movie. This is Orson Krennic, the director of Advanced Weapons Research. And this is Galen Erso, the lead engineer on the Death Star project. And this book was basically about them. They went to college together, and they were friends. And Galen was like a big pacifist and refused to work for the government. But Krennic knew he was going to need his help because he was this expert on crystallography, which is how they powered the Death Star with kyber crystals. So he had this kind of fake project called Project Celestial Power that was all about energy for outer rim planets, renewable energy, which was kind of his dream job. And so they tricked him into working on this project. And while I was reading this book, I'm like, yeah, yeah. Project Celestial Power, that sounds great. But then I'm like, why wouldn't he take this job? And I'm like, oh yeah, that's like, I know this is the Death Star project because I know what happens. So I got tricked into working on the Death Star project. And it made me think about my moral code and where my line in the sand is. And I think we all have a line in the sand. But the thing is that the moment that you're faced with an ethical dilemma isn't really a good time to start thinking about where that line is. Because then it's going to be easier to like get you to do things you don't want to do. And this is a first step to implementing self-accountability, which essentially just means don't do anything bad, even as a joke. I made this about a year ago, and I posted it on the internet. That's not my real information, because I'm not an idiot. But I thought this was very funny. And then I realized that if even one person didn't get the joke and like posted their information and their identity got stolen, I would be a bad person, so I took it down and I put it in my slides instead. And repurposed code is also a big thing. I like to use this example. If you feel strongly about something, you have to think about how that code can be repurposed. Maybe you get asked to do a job where they want you to do facial recognition software so they can identify and arrest protesters. And you're like, no, no, I'm not gonna do that. You know, that's not ethical. Well, if you feel really strongly about that, you should probably also not take a job doing facial recognition software for AR video games, because the software doesn't really care whose face it's recognizing. And your code could be used in a way that you don't feel comfortable with, which is exactly what happened with Galen Erso in the Death Star. And that's kind of why I related to him. And then Orson Krennic, I also really related to in a lot of ways. He was very ambitious. I am pretty ambitious. He did a lot of networking. I like to do networking. These are things that like I feel about myself. But it turns out that an unethical organization only cares about you for as long as you're useful to it. He kind of dedicated his whole life to the Empire. He kind of was a bad guy for his entire life just because he was trying to get ahead, which isn't a good reason to be a bad guy. But really, in the end, he gave them his life's work and made this weapon for them. And, you know, it didn't matter. What did he get? He got nothing. You know, they didn't care about him, and they let him get destroyed. So it didn't really work out for him either. Well, what's my conclusion? I don't really have all the answers, unfortunately. This is something that we've been thinking about since the beginning of time, really. But I hadn't really thought about my work in this way until I, you know, saw Rogue One, and it really changed the way I thought about it. And I think it's very important for us. I'm not going to tell you, here's the line, don't cross this line. We all have to decide for ourselves, but I think it's important to be well thought out about it and then implement self-accountability, like stick to our own principles. My hope is that if we all kind of think about that and are willing to do that, then we won't end up building the next Death Star. Thank you.